Hello guys, welcome to my channel. This is Uday Pandit and you are watching MEP Technical World. In this video, we will learn about how to implement phase failure relay with DG start and stop function. Okay, so before I start the session, I would like to request you, if you are not yet subscribed my channel, please subscribe my channel and also hit the bell icon so you'll get notification regarding my upcoming videos. So let's get started. So here I have taken VCFD2 phase failure relay. Actually VCFD2 is the model of this phase failure relay. We can also call it VMR relay, which is voltage monitoring relay. Okay, so here this is the real view of VCFD2 phase failure relay. Okay, so here this is the model number VCFD2 and which is made by Minilec, and here we have a reset button which is in red color. So we can reset this relay by pressing this button, okay, in case we have any fault or if this relay is in tripped condition. Okay, and here we have a two option for voltage setting. Okay, in percentage, one is for under voltage protection and other is for over voltage protection. So as you can see over here, in this under voltage setting, here we have a range from 75% to 95%. So within this range we can set the value with the help of a screwdriver by rotating this knob. Okay, similarly over here we have a over voltage percentage, which is also ranges from 105% to 120%. So within this range we can set the over voltage setting. Okay, so by rotating this knob. And another we have a indicators. Here we have a green indicator which indicates that our relay power is on, or we can say this relay is in normal condition. And remaining we have a two indicator which is in red color. One is for under voltage protection indicator and other is for over voltage protection. In case we have a under voltage fault, at that time this relay will glow, and if we have a over voltage protection, then at that time this indicator will be glow. So this is for basically monitoring purpose. And here we have a trip delay settings and power on relay settings. Actually this is for time setting. Suppose we have set here 5 seconds, okay, trip delay. So in case we have a fault like a over voltage fault, then this relay will trip after 5 seconds because we have given the trip delay 5 seconds. And with the help of this we can set the time delay for power on. Okay, now here we have a terminals. Okay, so at this condition we don't know so which terminal is for RYB connection and which is NONC common. So at this condition we don't know. So to know about all details of this connection or terminals, we need to read the circuit drawings or wiring diagram of this relay. So to read this wiring diagram, we need to look beside of this relay. So here, as you can see over here, so this is the circuit diagram. Here I have taken, so this is the circuit diagram actually. As you can see in this wiring diagram, here this is the VCFD2 model. And here under and over voltage relay protection which is made by Minilec, and here we have a terminal descriptions. So 1, 2, 3, and 1 is for R and 2 is for Y and B is for 3 and N is neutral for 4 numbers. So in this way we can connect one at one terminal, we can connect R and Y, 2 terminal Y and 3 terminal B, and at 4 terminal we can connect neutral also. Okay, so in this way we can identify these terminals. And here we have a 13 number and 16 number common terminal. So this is the 13 and 16 number is common terminal. Okay, so as you know that, so this wiring diagram is for when this relay is at energized condition. So actually this circuit diagram is for relay energized condition. Okay, so 13 number and 16 number is common terminal, 14 number is anode terminal with this 13 number, and 15 number is NC terminal with this 13 number common terminal. Similarly over here 17 number is NO with this 16 number, and 18 number is NC with this 16 number common terminals. However, we have a little bit confusion here. If we look into here 14 number contact, it is contacted with this 13 number. Okay, but it look like NC, but this is NO contact. I have already told you this diagram is for when the relay is at energized condition. That's why this NO contact is become NC at energized condition, and this NC contact become NO at energized condition. Okay, and here we have another block diagram of this relay. So it is in normal condition. Okay, so here we can connect R, Y, B, and here neutral. Okay, and these two are common terminal, 13 and 16 number, and 14 number is NO, and 15 number is NC. Okay, so this is in normal condition. When this relay gets energized, then its contact become changed. This 14 number NO contact become NC, and this 15 number NC contact become NO. So this is the actual drawing. Okay, here that's why I have told you. So this diagram is for when the relay is at energized condition. Okay, so in this way we can read the circuit diagram or wiring diagram before start the connection. Okay, now let's move to the basically what are the protection we'll get from this PCF D2 phase failure relay. So these are phase failure protection in case we have any fault among the three phases. At that condition this relay will be tripped. And another, we have a phase unbalance protection in case we have a phase unbalance between any two phases. At that condition this relay will be tripped, hence protects the system's load. Okay, and another is phase sequence protections. If the our RY phase sequence changed from outside or anywhere, suppose Y to R like this, at that condition this relay will also tripped. And here we have a three phase three wire under voltage and over voltage protection. In case we have a under voltage and over voltage, at that condition this relay will also get tripped. That's why we also call this relay is voltage monitoring relay. Okay, so these are the protection basically we get from this phase failure relay. Okay, now let's talk about some application of this VCF D2 phase failure relay. Here we have an application where we can use this relay. It can be used in auto main failures panel, which is AMF panels, or we can use it in ATS panel or DGSet panel or battery charger panel or UPS or in inverter panel. So these are the applications of this VCF D2 phase failure relay. Now let's implement the circuit or connection of VCF D2 phase failure relay with DG start and stop function. Okay, so here we are on implementation.
of this VCF D2 phase failure relay. Okay, so here I have taken phase failure relay. This is the VCF D2 model phase failure relay. Okay, and this part is for utility power supply. So these four bus bar are connected with this utility power supply line, or we can say CT line source. Okay, and R is connected at 1 number terminal, Y is connected at 2 number terminal, and B is connected at 3 number terminal, and neutral is connected at 4 number terminal. Okay, and here we have a two settings. I have already told you regarding under voltage percentage and over voltage percentage. So here I have set the value for under voltage protection at 90%, and for over voltage protection, which is at 110%. So actually, how to calculate the exact value of under voltage? If we set this at 90%, so what will be our exact value? We are taking our reference voltage is 415. Okay, so this is our reference voltage. Actually, we are getting this voltage from this utility supply. Okay, now for calculation, what we have to do, we need to calculate this under voltage protection. If we set this at 90%, then 90% of this voltage will be the under voltage trip value. Actually, let's calculate the value for under voltage. So let's take a calculator for that. Now here we have a calculator. Okay, now 90% means 0.9, as you know that if we calculate the percentage. So 90 divided by 100 means 0.9, and multiply with this reference voltage, which is 415 volt. Okay, and equal to 373.5 volt. So this is the under voltage trip value. In case our utility power supply voltage is reduced from 415 volt to 373.5, which is under voltage value as per the setting of this relay, then at that time this relay will be tripped because of under voltage. Okay, similarly over here, if we calculate the value for over voltage trip, here we have set the over voltage percentage at 110 voltage. Okay, so for that, if we calculate the over voltage trip value, then we have to calculate this 110% of this reference voltage, which is 415 volt. So let's calculate that. So 110% means 1.10, okay, and which is multiplied by this reference voltage, which is 415 voltage. So 415 voltage, and equal to this is 456.5. So this is the over voltage trip value. In case our utility supply voltage is increased from 415 volt to 456.5 volt, which is the over voltage setting as per this relay, at this level of voltage this relay will be tripped. Okay, this is for over voltage protection. So in this way we can calculate and we can set the knob for over voltage and under voltage. Okay, and here we have taken two contactor. Okay, one contactor is for utility and another contactor is for DG supply, and here we have connected load, which is at common bus bar. Okay, so here I'm not going to discuss about ATS panel, because so here I'm only focus on how to use this relay in the DC to make auto start and stop. Okay, in later video we'll discuss about complete information about ATS panel. Okay, so here we have taken DC, so this is the DC part. Okay, here we have a DC starter motor, this is the fuel solenoid valve. Okay, and this is the battery. Okay, with the help of this battery we can give the power to the this DC starter motor of this DC set and this solenoid valve, which is fuel solenoid valve. Okay, actually power supply of this DC starter motor and this valve is controlled through this relay. Okay, as you can see over here, positive terminal of this battery is connected at the common terminal of this phase failure relay or VMR relay, voltage monitoring relay, which is connected at 16 number and 13 number. Okay, so this is the common terminal of this relay. Okay, and from the 15 number terminal, which is the NC terminal of this relay. Okay, from here it is connected to the solenoid terminal. So here we have connected, which is positive terminal, and from the 18 number terminal, which is NC terminal of this phase failure relay, which is connected at positive terminal of this DC starter motor, and for negative terminal we have given through this black wire from this negative terminal of this battery, as you can see over here. Okay, so in this way we can connect the power supply of this DC starter motor and fuel solenoid valve with the help of this battery through this relay. Okay, now let's come to working of this system. Basically, how does this system work? Now at this condition we are assuming our utility supply line is present or available. So at this condition this load is actually operated through this utility line because our utility line is present. Okay, that's why this relay will sense the all the parameter of this utility line. Okay, including all phases should be present and phase sequence are okay. Even we don't have any under voltage and over voltage system, so all parameters of this utility line is okay. That's why this relay got energized, hence its NC contact become NO. As you can see over here, this is the NO, because initially this 15 number is, if we do not have this power supply, then this 15 number is NC actually. Now everything is okay, then at energized condition, here we have 15 number is now NO contact. That's why this motor and solenoid valve is not getting power from this terminal. Okay, because it is normally open. That's why in this condition our DC is at a stopped condition. Now let's assume our CT line is goes off. Okay, so here we have assumed our CT line is goes off. Now at this condition what happened, this relay will sense the power of this utility line. So this relay sense there is no utility power available, that's why this relay get de-energized, means deactivate, hence its contact become changed, it comes to normal position in this way, as you can see over here. Now this contact become now NC. Okay, so in this condition what happened actually, now this DC starter motor got positive supply terminal in this way and solenoid valve from this 15 number terminal, this will also get positive terminal power supply. Now this motor will start, so this fuel solenoid valve is also start on. Now in this condition what happened, this DC will started, and in this way now this DC is running condition. Okay, now actually this load is at this condition running with this DC set power supply. Okay, in this way now here our DC is still running because our utility or city line supply is not present. So this is running condition. Now let's assume again our city line will be back. So here our city line is back. Now in this condition, what happened? Again, this relay, phase failure relay, or we can say VMR relay, will sense the utility line power supply. So this will again check the condition. Every phases should be present, okay, and all phases should be in sequence like RYB. Even we don't have any phase unbalance, like we don't have any under voltage and over voltage as per this setting. So if all parameter is okay, then this relay will get energized. Hence again its contact get changed like this, as you can see over here. Now again this NC contact become NO here, as you can see. Again this DC motor starter and this fuel solenoid valve will not get a power supply, hence DG set will be off, means stopped. Okay, now this load is operating through at this condition this utility line. So actually in this way this system work. This video we have learned about how to implement this VCF D2 phase failure relay with this DG set to make auto start on and off. So hope you guys understand this session. So thank you for watching this video. So please like, share, comment and subscribe, and also hit the bell icon so you'll get notification regarding my upcoming videos. So thank you very much. See you again in next videos.